good. I'll see you shortly.
Drop out, just let me know. So I'm going up before the second piece, and I can tell everyone if it does start to drop out with phones and stuff.
Actually, let me use their link.
Oh, so it's good?
There's no issue at all.
Fuck yeah.
And it seems to be working fine. There's phones nice and smooth.
Alright, awesome.
So, yeah, I've just also put a link on Facebook.
Yeah.
Being safe and alive, let me know if there's any issues. So,
nice.
It should be okay.
Alright, awesome. Well, I'm going to go round up the troops and then we'll kick off. And you do the lights as well, yeah, Umberto?
Yeah, so the lighting will pretty much, but I'll always just increase a little bit the brightness. Well, do the
these dim and then stay dark.
And then probably leave it as it is on the stage, not too bright, not too dark.
Okay, perfect. Alright.
How are you? Good. Good to see you. When's it starting? Mind if I stand here?
Good evening, everyone. That's very loud. I'll just give you 2 seconds to grab a seat, get those last hugs in. right, good evening, everyone. My name's Callum Moncrieff. Before we get started, I'd just like to acknowledge the traditional owners of the land on which we meet, the Whadjuk Noongar people, and honour their elders past and present. I'd also like to acknowledge all First Nations people of Australia as the custodians of the world's oldest continuing music practice. So I'm going to be your MC of sorts this evening. I'm going to top and tail the night. I'm not going to talk too much, but before I get started, Holly wanted me just to explain to you who I am to her and Niels, just in case. So Niels and I were in the Air Force band together, but I first met Niels just after he'd moved to Melbourne about 8 years ago. And Holly and I had been in a relationship together here in Perth for nearly 5 years, but we had and have stayed friends. And thank you for laughing, Holly. Holly was visiting Melbourne in 2016, and she was super excited to introduce me to this great sax player who she'd met just before moving to Darwin. And obviously I thought that Niels was a legend when I first met him. Some would say that it could have been a complicated relationship when Niels, the husband of my former girlfriend, joined the Air Force band, but it never felt that way because that was the kind of person that Niels was. We shared together the highs and lows of having small children, living in Melbourne during the lockdown, and then both becoming reservists in the Air Force band. Niels was the most generous person. He helped me to prepare for an audition to conduct the band. He checked in with me when he was arranging percussion parts just to make sure that they were actually playable. And he just had a passion for music that was infectious. So we're here to remember Niels tonight through one of his favourite ways of communicating, which is, of course, his music. He was a monster player. His passion and dedication, as well as his ability, were what gave him an instant connection with other musicians around him. When he told me he was moving to Perth and that he had some reservations, I said that he would fit in very easily. The people here are amazing musicians, but they're also great people. And tonight we'll hear from you, these people that make up the Perth scene through his music, and it is an amazing lineup tonight. We've got some phenomenal musicians. The WA Jazz Project is something that Niels was immensely proud of, and I wasn't surprised as I watched from over east how quickly he became a respected member of this community. I'm not going to talk too much, but I would like to acknowledge those of you who have travelled from interstate to be here and those of you who are watching the live stream. The commanding officer of the Air Force Band, Squadron Leader Daniel Phillips, is here, and we'll have a moment for reflection later on. Now, it could be a sombre night tonight, and there will be times where you want to shed a tear, reflect on Niels and on what a loss his passing is for so many people. But it's also a night of great music. We want to celebrate that. So clap, cheer, say, yeah, man, during a good solo. And you know that's what Niels would have done. So let's make it a great hang for our friend Niels. So to kick that off, I'm just very excited to be standing on stage with some fantastic musicians who I haven't seen in a long time. Good to see you guys. We've got Jeremy Trezona, Matt Smith, Tom O'Halloran, Nick Abbey, and Ric Eastman. They're going to kick off the night for you.
Thank you.
Now, I just wanted to give you a bit of context for the next piece. Now, that piece we just heard, Monday Nights at BMH, which was, of course, written by Niels. If you haven't got a program, they are available at the door hole over there. And if you'd like to buy a CD, they're on sale. I think it's No Time for Talkers. I don't know if it's just that one. Yeah, so $27.50. So do please, if you haven't got one, go and see Travis. He's over there at the door. And, yeah, look, some context for this next piece, because we heard from one of Niels's friends from UNT, and when he commenced studying at the University of North Texas, which he has said was one of the happiest times of his life as a musician. And when he went over there, he lived with three other sax players. I don't know if that's connected with being the happiest times of his life. I couldn't think of anything worse. But I lived with trumpet players, though, and that's pretty bad. Sorry, Matt. Come on. John Sawyer was one of these sax players, and he sent through some thoughts just about this piece and about Niels, and I thought I'd just pull a few out to let you know. And so this piece was written about their first address. It was on Wintercreek Drive. So Niels and John used to love watching a TV show called House together, which if you don't know or you might remember, it had Hugh Laurie as a grumpy doctor, and the quartet binged the show for an entire weekend once. And that was before it was cool to binge TV shows. Another memory for them, they made a trip to Applebee's in the snow, which is a restaurant over there. And Niels, this is my favourite, Niels told John that Vegemite was a chocolatey snack. You only make that mistake once. But they also had many long and deep conversations about who they were. And, you know, this was something that I agree with John. That's one of Niels's, one of his best qualities, having a good chat. And I'd like to welcome Gemma Farrell to join the rest of the players up here for Wintercreek Drive.
Hi everyone, my name's Johannes and I'll be playing a tune for you now. Looking at the program, you'll see there's lots of work by Niels and then you'll see there's me playing a song from Star Wars. And I thought it'd be a good idea to give some context for why I'm doing that. I'm gonna be playing Across the Stars, which is the love theme from episode 2, Attack of the Clones. Not the best film in the franchise, but it has some really wonderful music. And when Holly asked if I would play something, I was trying to think of what I could possibly do to contribute to this beautiful night. And I thought back to one of the last conversations I had with Niels. Was sitting in Matilda's bedroom drinking wine and talking about film music and how much we both loved it. And Niels was talking about how much he loved the music of John Williams. And we, you know, as you do, we were kind of bonding over a mutual appreciation of some of the wonderful music that is in Star Wars in particular. So this is for Niels and this is for another Star Wars nerd in the room, Holly.
Thank you. I wrote down what I was going to read because I was extra nervous. Niels and I met in this room at a similar time of the year to now, just before Christmas 8 years ago. He was standing right over there talking to Mace Francis. There was an expat big band playing Christmas tunes, lots of musicians based elsewhere who'd come home to spend time with their families. Mace introduced us and we got to talking about studying music in the US. Niels had been in Texas, I'd been in Miami, and we had some mutual friends overseas. It's pretty easy to fall in love with a musician because you inhabit the same world, but it was really easy to fall in love with Niels. He wore his heart on his sleeve and looked at the world with delight and reverence. We're going to play a song that I wrote for Niels. It's not the only song I ever wrote for him, and it's not the happiest song I ever wrote for him. I wrote it when he was sick and played it for him. We both cried. He remarked afterwards that he was so glad something had made him cry because he was finding it really hard to access emotions. It's a very personal song, but I wanted to play it one more time for him. Takes two, and you're the one for me. That's why we promised we would always be a team. And you're the first one to admit that the last few years have not always been kind. I know you're good and bad. The things that make you smile and make you mad.
Where you went and be my teammate again.
Thank you. I'm going to swap out for my brother, Tom Norman.
And just to let you know who these fantastic musicians who are just leaving the stage, Nick Abbey, Emily Gelineau, we had Julia Watson here and Anna Sarcich. And a beautiful piece of music. So I'm going to introduce now Tom Norman, who Niels is a brother-in-law, and Tom's asked me to introduce him. He had a case of laryngitis. So he's going to sing a beautiful song for us. I Just Don't Think I'll Ever Get Over You by Colin Hay. Tom Norman.
I don't know if this is coming out or not. Yep. I just want to say it's really unfair that Holly made me follow that. And I know that was part of her plan. So let's see how I survive this. I drink a coffee every morning. Comes from a place that's far away. And when I'm done, I feel like talking. Without you here, there is less to say. Don't want you thinking I'm unhappy. What is closer to the truth? As if I lived till I was 102, I just don't think I'll ever get over you. No longer move to drink strong whiskey. I touched the hand of time and I knew that if I live till I can no longer climb my stairs, I just don't think I'll ever get over you. Your face, it dances and it haunts me. Your laughter still ringing in my ears. I still find pieces of your presence here. Even after all these years, I don't want you thinking that I don't get asked to dinner, 'cause I'm here to tell you that I sometimes do. And if I feel just a touch of love, I just don't think I'll ever get over you. And if I live till I was 102, I just don't think I'll ever get over you.
Oh, it's me again. I was tasked with introducing this tune because Niels and I actually wrote this song together for a project that I did earlier in the year. And it made me realise when I got up to introduce it, I was really intimidated by him musically for like a long time, actually. It's difficult to let somebody in that way, even though you share that. But it was really nice to get to a point where we were able to appreciate music together, and we were able to write music together and play music together, and that's something that, yeah, I just absolutely loved. So this tune's called Post-Swim Feeling. We wrote it about coming over and swimming in the Indian Ocean after we'd been in lockdown for 10,000 years, making it over to WA. The water had that really redemptive quality, and Niels was just a spirit of the water. Absolutely loved the ocean. So this is Post-Swim Feeling.
Thank you.
Thank you. That is the end of the first half of this concert, so please have a drink and see you in the second half when there is a lot of big band music.
I'm going to
Hi, everyone. Welcome back. There's more musicians on stage for us. This is exciting. So just a quick story before we get to go. I mentioned earlier about Niels and before he moved to Perth, how he mentioned he was a bit worried about his musical life. But I told him that the Perth scene is fantastic, amazing players and great people. And you have embraced him because that's what you are. And the outpouring of love during this most difficult time has really shown how much the Perth music scene cares for each other and for its own. So this is a great example of that. The West Australian Jazz Project, formed in 2021 by a handful of Perth musos as a way of activating the Perth Concert Hall as a venue for jazz music. Niels was the artistic director of a gig they did earlier this year for Comic-Con. And I'm now going to welcome to the stage the West Australian Jazz Project with Groove Merchant. Thank you.
Now I don't have to yell. This is much nicer. Holly asked me if I would like to say a few words about Niels, and of course it's my absolute privilege to be able to. Seeing so many people here tonight is really heartwarming. Niels and I were friends for only a short while, much too short. I heard about Niels before I met him. The first thing I heard about him was that he was an awesome saxophone player, who I should really check out. I can't remember who told me that I needed to check him out, but anyway. Ah, there you go. Thank you, Sarah. Then I heard about Niels from a mutual friend in Melbourne who called to let me know that Niels was going to be moving to Perth with Holly, who I already knew, and Matilda. He told me Niels was an amazing player, an excellent teacher, and a great guy. And he said, I think you're really going to like him. I ended up meeting Niels at the media launch for the WA Jazz project. Niels was there with Holly, and he was very excited about the Christmas theme for our first concert. Turns out, Niels loves Christmas and Christmas songs, and had already bought tickets to see the show. So we chatted about all things saxophone and music and mutual friends in Melbourne, and it felt like I was catching up with an old friend, like not like we'd just met. Anyhow, shortly afterwards, Wadjup found itself in need of another saxophone player, and so lots of conversations were had, and before long Niels became a member of the band, a much loved and valued member. And he was even more excited about the Christmas theme for our debut. When my friend Adam had called to tell me about Niels moving here, he asked if I knew of any saxophone teaching available, which at the time I didn't. But I said I'd keep an ear out. And fast forward, one of the saxophone tutors at the school where I teach left, and it seemed like it was just meant to be. So Niels was employed to teach at Howe School. The students were all smitten with him. Miss, he's such a goat. Have you heard him play? Yeah, greatest of all time. Through all of this, through doing gigs, days of teaching, post-gig hangs, my friendship with Niels continued to grow. Interestingly, after one of our gigs, we were hanging out talking about stuff, you know, music, people, friendships, the meaning of life, as you do. I told Niels that I didn't really have any head or heart room for any more friends, but I'd made the conscious decision to make an exception for him. Niels was such a warm and caring human. He would pop his head into the music office every day he taught to smile and say hi, that cheeky grin where he'd just go, hey. And then he'd pop his head in again at the end of the day to say goodbye. He checked in with me often to see how I was doing and was always available for a chat. Niels was effervescent and sincere and kind. He was a good person. He always saw the best in everyone. He's had such an impact on everyone around him, and I'm grateful to have known him. I am so fortunate to have some very special, trusted and much loved long-time friends in my life. I don't take this for granted. Quite a few of them are here in the audience or on stage with me tonight. But I am so, so sad that my new friend Niels is not with us anymore. All the repertoire we've chosen to play tonight is significant in one way or another. I once had a discussion with Grant Windsor about how lovely Niels was and how genuinely delighted he was to be playing Christmas songs. Grant commented, "Neil is Christmas, wrapped up in a person." It's fitting then that we will be playing Drew Zaremba's arrangement of the Christmas song, which was written for Niels tonight. And you'll also hear some big band favourites, tunes that we know he loved playing, and some of Niels' compositions and arrangements. I think I can safely say that everyone here loved Niels. I hope you feel that love in our farewell to Niels tonight. Music speaks louder than words.
Thank you. Oh, no, nice. Hi, everyone. They got the Kenny G button going. Come on. I've just put my soprano down now, too. Neil's like Kenny G, right? No, he did. Hey, we had a lot of chats about Kenny G. We loved him, all right? Really. It was up there with Dave Werkle. The last tune, you gave me the microphone. The last tune was a tune by Niels called The Quintessential Count. And he's kind of got the flavour of Count Basie down beautifully. And even the melody to start off with, it sort of sounded like a Christmas tune. It really did. All right, enough of me. That's what everyone else is saying behind me anyway. Here is now the overture to the Nutcracker Suite. Yes, it's another Christmas. All right, this next one is not that one. Brad?
Oh, not that one?
No, it is that one.
All right.
But you can hold the mic.
Because only my All right, so Matt's going to get his iPad. I've only met Niels shortly and had just utterly blown away by his playing, and just such a sweet guy. And now we're going to play. What are we going to play?
That one.
We're going to play "Hey Burner" by Sam Ionescu, which I don't know why. What's? Oh, it's the saxophone solo. That's right. It's one of the most famous saxophone solos in the Count Basie repertoire. Absolutely fantastic. We may have played it once or twice before. He's still updating his iPad. And let's see.
Yeah, come on! Niels wouldn't approve of that joke. Thank you. Lovely save.
Thank you.
now we're doing this one. This one is called Blues in Frankie's Flat, also known as Blues in Hoss's Flat. Frank Foster.
I believe this is the first tune that Niels ever played with this band.
We'll be right back. All right, are you ready for an experiment? Okay, this is the wonderful Christmas song arranged by Drew Sarimba. And this is an experiment because we've not played it before. And there's a couple of it's a couple of points in here that we need to discuss. So talk amongst yourselves. Wait, does anyone know F sharp on trumpet? Is that D trumpet or C? It's the long trumpet. That trumpet. Does anyone know that it's the middle thing? No. Okay, so band, we're going to start at bar 12. Okay, all right. I've been overruled. Wait, you talked about it? Well, you didn't tell me about it. I've got the mic. Yeah, all right. We're not going to start at bar 12. We are? Okay, we're going to nail this. We're going to start at bar 5. Now, while we're waiting for something, I will tell you one story that Niels and I, well, that involved Niels and I. And we were chatting one day, and it's and like Mel said, it's not often that you find someone who's had very similar experiences. Now, when I was in living in London, I joined a band called NYJO, National Youth Jazz Orchestra. And the only person I know in Perth that I've ever come across, in fact Australia, who's also had the same experience in the same band was Niels. And not only that, there was you had the sax section, and essentially if you wanted a gig, what you had to do, you had to roll up to the rehearsal, sit next to the person who was playing the pad that you wanted to play and outplay them. And that rehearsal. And at the end of the rehearsal, the guy would come along and go, "You're doing a gig, you're doing a gig, you're doing a gig." And so even if you did that gig that week, you would have to come back the following week and outplay the person that you outplayed the week before. And Niels and I, we really bonded over this. But not only that, but this big band has a very, very rare chair or a position, and that was a flute chair. And it was a dedicated just flute chair. And he's the only person I know that I've ever talked to in the years that I've been alive who did the same thing as I did. Walked in, saw the flute chair, got the flute chair. Then, about 4 weeks later, sat next to the first tenor chair and got the first tenor chair. And Niels and I, obviously at different points in our lives, had the same experience. And he's the only person I know who had exactly the same experience in exactly the same building doing exactly the same thing just a few years apart, which is just quite incredible. All right, Christmas song. Do you guys know what you're doing? Starting from whatever bar you want. So we're starting at bar 5. Well, why don't we go bar 5 at the same tempo as bar 12 for safety? Is that a good thing? Great. 80? It really is. Niels would approve. They love this stuff. Yeah, we're good. Bar 5, crotchet equals 80, folks, just in case anyone wanted to check that one. Thank you. Good luck. See you at the end. Thank you.
Thank you.
Jeremy Trezona on the tenor. Callum.
Okay, I'd now like to welcome to the stage the commanding officer of the Royal Australian Air Force Band, Squadron Leader Daniel Phillips.
Good evening, everyone. Definitely a room full of love here tonight, so it is a great privilege to be here. So, to Holly, John and Teresa, thank you for having us. It means a lot. I have two points that I want to cover, and I promise I will be as brief as possible. From the time Niels joined us in 2018, he displayed all of the values that we keep very dear to our hearts: his professionalism, his mateship, his humour. Like I said the other day, that beautiful goofy laugh, you know, was just this normally the start of a really good conversation. So I can say I've been in this job for 28 years, and Niels will be cherished as one of our finest. To be slightly more formal, what does the Air Force Band do? I know I love you all, but being here in Perth, you don't really get a chance to see us, unfortunately. I would love to jump on a plane and bring the band over here and all that kind of stuff, but what do? We represent the Air Force, we represent the Australian Defence Force, we commemorate, we celebrate, and we remember. We travel internationally, we travel around the country, we go all over the place, and we do these things to represent and to value those that have come before us, okay? One of the things that we will be doing in a moment is doing exactly that for one of ours. Thankfully, I haven't had to do this before for one of my own. Before we do that, though, and if I can just ask you to hold my hand for a second, please. Mate, there's a small formal presentation here. So I never got the chance to present this to Niels. He's entitled to his first medal. This is the Australian Defence Medal, which is given to ADF members for 4 years' service. And I'd just like to present this to Holly on behalf of the Chief of Air Force. Just before Holly goes, we've also put together a beautiful little memento board.
Oh, that's so nice.
So there are elements here. I'm sure you can all come and have a look. But the effect of his short time in the band was deeply, deeply felt, and it even went to the extent that he was awarded a commendation alongside a bunch of people from the band for his contribution to the 2019 Royal Edinburgh Military Tattoo in Sydney, for which Niels contributed the entire Australian marching band's arrangements, as well as a whole bunch of other things. Even if he had to write for bagpipes, which we had great delight in doing. Right. So, please, for yourself and for Matilda, to remember him. Thank you. So again, I am very privileged and thankful that we've been given the opportunity to come over, and I've brought over one of my finest buglers, Michael Fraser, to perform the next part of the evening. Thank you. So for those of you who are able to stand, ladies and gentlemen, please be upstanding.
They shall grow not old, as we who are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. at the going down of the sun, and in the morning, we will remember them. Lest we forget.
Thank you, everyone. I think it's only fitting, before we play the very last tune of the night, that if you've got a glass of something, that we toast the man himself. Here's to the great man who will be missed by many, to Niels. It's been quite a night, don't you think? And a very fitting night. And you've heard the amazing testimony just from people playing how much a part of the about of the scene he is here in such a short space of time. To kind of bring a bit of Melbourne to Perth, we've got a very special guest up the back. And we all have something in common. We've never seen this chart before, so this is going to be really good. Sorry, we have played this part before. Okay. And I think this tune is a tune, clearly, you know, it's been written and titled by Niels, but it kind of sums up a lot of our experience, I think, with him. And it's really, it's get on with the music. No time for talkers. Thank you.
Thank you.
And there we have it. Come on. Thank you all, ladies and gentlemen. To Holly, Tilly. Good night, everyone. Thank you.